since the beginning of time with the ancient Egyptians, through the origins of Buddhism, through the Renaissance, and in our modern art, through our music, and our sports, and now at East Chapel Hill High.
So when I first came home with my mullet, my parents were, especially my mom, she was real worried that she thought I would like do drugs and all that, you know. She thought I would go down the wrong path in life because mullets really put you in a different category. My dad, he was real happy for me though, because he knew that my life was just going to be extraordinary from that day on, and that there was no turning back. And he was real proud of me as a father, you know, that really made me happy.
Fine alle mullete. The mullet first originated in Antarctica. The Inuits used it as a way to keep them warm, but also as a way for them to see when they are hunting. Throughout history, it's grown into one of the most popular hairdos, especially with the Egyptians. The ancient rulers used this as to express power among their servants, especially the Jews.
Mullets are out of fashion. You can't have a mullet anymore.
Mullets are shit.
I think the president should make everyone get a mullet at least once in their life. It helps someone grow as an individual.
Well, I first had my mullet around age 7. And that's when I really started developing these guns right here. Started playing basketball. I could dunk by age 10. And I was playing college ball around age 14. So I was really ahead of the curve. And I owe it all to this mullet right here.
In my experience as a tennis coach, I think kids with mullets tend to be the most aerodynamic. It's something about the style of hair. It tends to be, they're a lot faster, a lot more agile. I definitely think it's been my experience that it's to their benefit to have the mullet haircut. The long hair really gets in the way, and the, you know, that style tends to intimidate the opponents as well.
My friends, they were always envious. They tried to grow a mullet themselves. Never really worked. And so I was really the most popular kid in school. Got all the ladies. And I actually had the 3 prom dates in my senior prom.
And guys just look better with mullets because you know they can party, but they can bring home money too.
I think mullets are really hot.
From there, I went to Wall Street, made a lot of money in the stock market. I retired by age 25 with a $2 billion estate, Los Angeles. And now I'm just going around the world preaching about mullets. Basically, anyone could have one, wishes they had one, anything. I say go for it because it's really changed my life and I really am grateful to have one.
Well, last year I almost had a mullet, but decided not to do it because, you know, I was thinking, well, if I go around school with a mullet, people are going to talk about it and I'm going to get a bunch of unwanted attention. But I mean, the real thing was my parents were freaking out. I mean, if I had it my way, I would keep the mullet. You know, I mean, I heard that saying on TV, it's all business in the front and all party in the back. And I was just, you know, it really struck a chord with me. Because, you know, to have that ability, I mean, you can just go anywhere and it's like, turn, everybody sees you in the front, oh, it's serious business. And they see you from the back and they're like, wow, that is one cool guy.
So basically the invention of roller coasters is due to me. Around age 30, I started working with metals, wheels and all that kind of stuff, and put 2 and 2 together and I made a roller coaster. And so anytime you're on a roller coaster, it has my name on it, because I'm the inventor of those.
You want to talk to me about mullets? Let me tell you, can't grow one now, but back in the day, like I'm not going to say how far back in the day, but back in the day, I had a mullet, and I want to tell you what, I was known as the ladies' man. Okay? I was a player. All right? So all you guys out there, you got the hair, I grow a mullet. Be a player. See you later.
Well, my most recent run-in where my mullet has gotten me better praise would be, went to the library, and usually they require you to have a pass, but of course, this mullet here was my pass.
Are you serious?
Yeah. All right,
come on, Jerry.
What about
you?
Like,
no, I don't have one.
Oh,
but I think you should be able to come in.
Really?
That would be.
A,
what?
I could have had her if I wanted to, but she really wasn't my type, so I didn't want to go for her. But yeah, I got in, and my friends didn't, and I owed all the mullet. So.
The mullet has had a great effect on society. Ever since it was created, ever since it was founded, the people with mullets have been far superior to anybody with short haircuts or any different hairstyles. It's more of an empowerment than a hairdo. It's something more than hair. It's something that sends a message, a strong message.
Before I had a mullet, I had dreads. I really thought that was gonna be good, but it didn't work. I had to drive around in an old Cadillac, and that was just no fun. So then I went for the buzz cut, and you know, people kept asking me, hey, when do you get back from Iraq? And I was like, no, I'm still here. So that's when I landed on the mullet, and it was a winner. I stuck with it ever since.
My experience, every student in the school that does have a mullet haircut is awesome, and I say rock on.
I had been researching mullets before I actually had one, and I saw the effects that they had, so I thought I'd give it a shot, and once I realized that I could pull it off, there's no turning back. I mean, why wouldn't I have one? It looks great, I feel great, nothing bad about it.
I long for those glory days. Oh, when my hair would flow back and I could keep it short. Mulletism, the era of joy, goodness, and beauty. Where have those days gone?
The other day, I saw a man talking, and this is what he said. He said to me, he said, son, your hair is real short, but then no bag is long. Well, if it is, and it really is, then you can sing my mullet song. And then he said to me, do you got a mullet?
Sing it loud.
A mullet going on.
Come on my head.
And do you got a mullet?
Yeah, bang your head.
It's beautiful, big and long.
It's real long.
Well, now, if you got a mullet, then there's no need to hide.
No need to hide, be proud.
It's plain to see, it's just so plain to me.
What are you going to do when you go bald?
You know what? I really don't want to talk about that right now. I'm going to cross that bridge when I get to it. And, you know, it's just something that I don't talk about. So, next question.
So plain to me.
So plain to me.
Now the problem is just with these kids, they got mullet jealousy.
And it's
do you got a mullet?
Uh-huh.